makes you think that you can save the people of the city?
It doesn't matter. I will save my people.
Why don't you understand? The people of the city are not worth saving.
Every life is important and I will save them.
Let's see then.
This is what we are going to create in Unity, a cutscene in Unity. So let's start creating one. There are different techniques by which you can create a cutscene in Unity. In this video, I'm just sharing one such method, which involves more of timeline. We will be using a lot of timeline. Also, if you need a detailed tutorial on timeline, do let me know in the comment section down below, so I'll just create one. Now let's create a cutscene. Things that we need first. Number one, an asset or an environment. I'm using an asset that I downloaded from the asset store, so you can download one or just create one of your own. So this is where our scene is going to take place. Number two, a story or a scene. So get the story or the scene planned out first. So what the actions are, what the character is going to do, all those stuff. So I have first planned the scene in a notepad of what's going to happen in the scene. Number three, the characters. For my story, I'm using two different characters. You would have your own game character on your own, but I don't have one for this video, so I'm using a Mixamo character. So I need two characters. Go to Mixamo character library, and I'm just choosing these two characters, an archer and a monster. Number four, animations for the character. So as per your scene that you have planned, you need the animations for that. If you have your own characters, get all the animations ready, either make it in Blender or Maya or whatever it is. In my case, all my characters are from Mixamo, so I'm getting all these animations from Mixamo animation library itself. You can either have animations like mine, I mean separately, or you can have all the animations in one file, so it's up to you. I need my character animations. So as per my story, initially the characters are idle, and then they start talking, and then it turns out to be an argument, and then they get ready for the fight, and then they attack each other, and finally one wins. So I need the idle. So idle, download. Talk, download. Another talk, download. So just go ahead and download all the required animations. Now all set and ready. Get into Unity now. Create a new folder, name it Archer. Import all the animation files for the Archer into that folder. Create another folder for Monster and do the same. Initially, when you import the character, you might not see the textures. So select the character file that you're going to use in the scene. So select the character, select Materials tab, and change the location from Use Embedded Materials to Use External Materials Legacy, and hit Apply. This will fix all the textures. Now drag and drop that file into the hierarchy window and place the character in a place where you want it to be in. So position it nicely. Now repeat the same for monster character as well. Now rename both the game objects properly. Archer, monster, done. While positioning the second character, you don't have to do it again. So just copy the component values from the first character and paste the component values to the second character. Now both characters are in place. Let's play the game. Woo! There is no camera. Let's create a camera then. Hit CTRL-SHIFT-F to align the camera view to the perspective view. Now let's play the game. Oh, still nothing is there. That's because both game objects doesn't have animator controller attached to them. But you know what? We don't need an animator controller for creating a cutscene here, because we're just using the timeline here. Now, how do we use a timeline? First, create an empty game object and rename it as timeline. Open up your timeline window. If you don't see the timeline window, go to Window, Sequencing, Timeline. Now you should see this window. Timeline is related to a game object, so you can create multiple timelines. If you need a detailed video on timeline, let me know in the comment section down below. Now select the timeline game object and create a timeline in the timeline window. I hope that's not confusing. Timeline itself is a separate file type, so it is a separate asset, so it gets saved in your project folder. Now name the timeline file as cutscene1 timeline and save it. Now a timeline is created. Cool. An animated timeline is created here, which I don't really need it. So click on the add button here and add an animation track. A new animation track is created. The animator has nothing in it. So click on the small dot and you will see all the game objects that has the animator component. Select Archer. Now add multiple animation tracks for your other characters as well. I'm creating a new one for Monster. Nothing happens because there is no animation data in it. Let's start arranging the downloaded animation files as per the sequence into the timeline. So my sequence is this. Characters idle, talks, argues, fights, defeats. So as per the scene, the character is idle at first. So select the Archer idle animation and expand the file. Now select only the animation clip and drag and drop it into the timeline. Now the animation is playing. Yay! You can also add this by right clicking on the animation track and add animation clip. This displays all the animation clips that you have imported. Here all the animation clips are named as Mixamo.com because all of these are from the Mixamo.com. I haven't renamed them. You can rename them if you want to, but I'm not going to use this method anyway, so I don't really care about it. Now do the same for monster character as well. Now if you want to split the track, hit S. I don't want this extended animation here, so just delete it. Now both characters are idle first. Now we need the character talking. Monster talks first, so arrange monster talking animation clip in the timeline. Animation is not smooth here, it's jumpy here. You can just blend two animation files in the timeline by just moving them over each other. The overlapped area gets blended. So overlap and adjust accordingly for your desired result. Mouse scroll up and down to zoom in and zoom out of the timeline. Since timeline is object related, when you select any other object, the timeline goes off because timeline game object has the timeline attached to it. It's not attached to anything else. Alright, now Archer is talking. Blend the animations. Arrange all the animations properly so that they make sense. When monster is talking, Archer has to be idle, and then when the Archer is talking, monster has to be idle, so that there is a proper animation sequence where acting and reacting is handled properly. Now you know your animation sequence, just go ahead and arrange them in sequence. Just keep adding the animation files and just blend them. Now here, the character is jumping on the other one. But ignore that for now, we will fix that in some time. I have arranged all the animations and sequence now, and let's take a look at it. I can notice there is a little bit of lag at some places, and also the initial idle is not required. It's kind of boring. So let's remove those and adjust the timing a little bit. It takes a little time, but as long as you have planned everything, you're good. I guess we're good now. Let's take a look at it. Yes. Now they are acting and reacting on time, arguing and fighting properly. Now one thing to fix here, that is the position of the characters when they are fighting and jumping. There is a record button here to animate the character inside Unity. When you hit the record button, you will get an error because the animation clip itself is already animated and you cannot override the animation directly. So right click on it and add override track. Rename the track as Archer Transform. So this will allow you to animate the overall global position of the character itself. You can animate the position, rotation, and the scale of the character. Hit record button and recording starts immediately. Now select the Archer game object from the scene and start positioning it. It automatically creates keyframes, thus animating the game object. Scrub through the timeline and position the character. Here, when the monster hits Archer, I want the Archer to be pushed back slightly. So move a few frames on the timeline and move the Archer slightly back. So monster hits and the Archer gets pushed back. Now coming to the monster, after hitting, monster moves back as its root joint is animated and the animations are blended here. So we will have to fix that too manually. Stop the recording for Archer. Create an override track for monster. Rename it hit record. Pull back the monster to the same position. There is a slight jerk when the animations blend, but here there is a graph editor for this animation that we have created. Click on this graph editor. So open graph editor, scroll down, select the keys, right click, both tangents, change the tangents as linear. Still it's not fixed. So we might have to do it a little bit more manually by adjusting the in-between frames. Now the animations are done. We need camera animation now. Add another animation track. There is no object in the animation track, so click on the dot to add the camera. The camera is not listed here. That's because Unity thinks that camera is not an animatable game object. When you select Archer or a monster, under the inspector window, you can see animator component is added, but the camera doesn't have one. So select the camera, add component, search for animator and add it. Now if you try to add the camera, it will be listed. Let's start animating the camera now. Hit the record button and animate the camera. Position the camera properly. When the second character starts speaking, we need to shift the camera on the other side. So after completing the camera animation, stop the recording. You might not see the animation clip in the timeline, so right click on the track and select convert to clip track. Shot 1 is added now. Done. So the first camera animation is ready. Let's do the same for the second shot. Go to the frame right next to the end of the previous shot and start recording. This will create a new clip. After finishing the second clip, just play it and see if they're all working fine. All good. Now go ahead and create any number of cameras that you need and rearrange them in the timeline. All the animations are done. So you can add different tracks to the timeline. You can add an audio track, so you can add music and sound effects, and there are a lot of other things too that you can add in the timeline, so which we'll talk about in a different video. But for now, this is just a cutscene. So that's it. Your cutscene is ready now. You can use triggers to spawn or instantiate the timeline object when the character enters the trigger, or you can add a separate scene file itself, whichever works for you.
What makes you think that you can save the people of the city?
It doesn't matter. I will save my people.
Why don't you understand? The people of the city are not worth saving.
Every life is important and I will save them.
Let's see then.
So, that's it. The cutscene is ready. So if you have any questions or queries, just let me know in the comment section down below, so I'll be happy to help you. So that's it, your cutscene is ready.